Concerning escalation in tensions between China and Taiwan, the Chinese ambassador to Australia claiming Beijing has the right to use military force to invade Taiwan. The comments made during an address to the National Press Club in Canberra. Nine's political editor Chris Uhlmann was there and he joins us now. Chris, good morning to you. When you heard those comments yesterday, I mean, it was pretty provocative. What did you think?
Well, Carl, we've heard it before. China's made no secret of the fact that it reserves the right to take Taiwan by force. And what we've seen this week is exactly that, a dress rehearsal for what an invasion would look like. The Chinese ambassador yesterday, his role at the press club really was to say that he wanted a reset with Australia, that there are lots of positives in the relationship and we should be talking those things up. The problem is, of course, with China is it's always all Australia's fault for the state of the relationship. And what we've seen around Taiwan is a demonstration of what China's been doing in front of and behind the scenes for years now, and that is preparation essentially to flex its muscles in this region, and that goes well beyond Taiwan into the South China Sea and into the South Pacific.
There are all sorts of repercussions that will come from that, and we know already a lot of businesses have supply issues with goods and services, mainly goods obviously coming out of China. We've known this might be coming. I know a lot of businesses are pivoting, but there's going to be enormous ramifications if this happens.
We're seeing it now, Carl. 90% of the world's chips for things like refrigerators, for cars, all kinds of electronic equipment now are being held up because of the post-COVID, you know, the slowdown that we've had. But China surrounded Taiwan this week and 90% of those chips come from there. Imagine if China had a stranglehold on that marketplace, and we can't quickly make those kinds of things in other parts of the world. The Americans are trying to do it at the moment, but it'll be years before that's really up and running. But the real issue in all of this, Carl, is that this is an island of 26 million people that has never been ruled by the Chinese Communist Party, which would rather not be ruled by the Chinese Communist Party. And the Chinese Communist Party is saying it reserves the right to take that island by force. And there's every indication that it will do that in the next couple of years. If it does that, then everything changes. I can think of another island of 26 million people that might have at least some interest invested in that.
I can see what you're putting down. You also laid your cards on the table yesterday. This is your question to the ambassador. Let's have a look.
Nope.
OK, you know what I'm saying, though. The question that you asked the ambassador, what did you make of his response to your question?
Yeah, well, the question really was, because he was talking about the fact that we needed to respect international law and that we needed to have positive policies, so I just laid out some of the areas where I think that China flies in the face of its words, and that is it's occupied and militarised the South China Sea in defiance of international law. In recent times, it threatened an Australian RAF plane in those waters, which was flying in accordance with international law. It holds our Australian citizens, two of them at the moment, and has tried them in secret. So in defiance of natural rights. It's interfered in our politics, in our universities, and in our Chinese diaspora here in Australia directly. And the Chinese ambassador described the people in Australia, the 1.2 million Chinese Australians, as overseas Chinese. Now, that's a term that they use, which means that those people owe some fealty to China. So we have an enormous problem with China. What China says and what China does are two very different things. And I've been trying for the last 7 years to get people to recognise that this is a threat that we must face, and we must face it with clear and open eyes and not listen to what China says, but watch what it does.
Chris Uhlmann, thank you. With a significant escalation in China's tension towards Taiwan, with Australia feeling the fallout, conflict between the superpower and its island neighbour all but inevitable, China's ambassador declaring, "We will take Taiwan." And new developments overnight. Beijing confirming it has ended almost a week of military war game drills around the island. Australia, meantime, watching the situation closely, likely to be drawn into military conflict if China was to launch an attack. A lot of things going on. Rhys D'Alessandro is following developments from Canberra. Rhys, a change in tack from Beijing.
Yeah, most certainly is, Carl, and hopefully this is the first step in the right direction. The notice from China's People's Liberation Army coming almost a week after these live fire exercises began. Beijing sending military ships and planes across the midline separating the two sides in the Taiwan Strait, also launching missiles into the waters surrounding the Democratic Island. This morning, China's military is saying sea and air operations were successful and have now concluded. It follows yesterday's address by China's ambassador to Australia, Australia, who called for a positive reset of relations with Australia. He made no apology, though, for the dangerous interception of an Australian plane by a Chinese fighter jet, saying it was in Chinese airspace. That is, of course, disputed by our Defence Force. The bigger picture, though, and the bigger concern is Beijing's future intentions with its island neighbour.
We're waiting for a peaceful unification. But we can never rule out our option to use other means. So when necessary, when compelled, we are ready to use all necessary means. As to what does it mean by all necessary means, you can use your imagination.
Yeah, frightening comment to say the least, Carl. While these particular war games might have just concluded, the Army will continue to carry out military training and is organising, quote, normalised combat readiness security patrols in the Taiwan Strait.
Rhys, thank you. China might have stopped its military drills over Taiwan, but it's warning it will still take the island. Attention having direct impact on us. Zoe, how did you feel listening to that yesterday, and how's the government preparing?
Look, I'm concerned. I'm very concerned. And as a former foreign correspondent, obviously, I keep a very close eye to what's going on internationally. The situation between China and Taiwan has been something that I've been watching nervously for some time. And obviously, we are in a period of potential escalation. So I think the point is really what Penny Wong, the foreign minister, has been saying. I agree with her. De-escalate. Strategic ambiguities worked quite well for a long time geopolitically when it comes to the relationship between China, Taiwan, and how we as a country and countries like the US view that. At the moment, the potential for miscalculation is very high. So I think everyone needs to remain calm.
I mean, if they take them, I'm not sure that what we're going to do about it in a physical sense. And obviously the world's going to react in a certain way, but I don't know what happens. Gus, I worry too about, Chinese Australians. This has an obvious impact on them, but also flow-on effects with supply for small businesses. I mean, they're never-ending results of this tension.
And that's all the work that we hear and the word we hear on Triple M, by blue-collar Aussies that are worried about the supply chain in one thing of getting their job done and getting money into their banks. But it wasn't great yesterday hearing from China and the fact that they're going to use any means necessary. We know exactly what that means. And, it sounds very much like they're going to run the rule whatever they want, and we can't do much about it.
Doesn't sound like it's far away.